All right, guys, I am in North Carolina. I'm about to watch a concert. Kimbra, she's one of my favorite artists. I didn't even know she was on tour. I knew her new album was coming out early this year, but I totally forgot about it, and I downloaded her album last night, and I went to her website, and I saw that, hey, she's going to be in Atlanta, and she's going to be also in this area, in the Chapel Hill area. So I thought, man, I'm gonna drive down here. It's about 5 hours. It's a five and a half hour drive, and I know it's, I ran into this couple who was going to see this concert as well, went to this parking garage, and they said, you know, 5 hours, 5.5 hours, pretty hardcore. They're from this area. And, you know, where I'm from, well, I'm from Flint. We don't get a lot of these type of concerts either. But in Pikeville, Kentucky, we definitely don't get these type of concerts. So I love this artist. I love beautiful women who can sing and create beautiful music. I love her composition, the music that she makes, because it's really interesting. A lot of these artists, you listen to them and every song sounds exactly the same. Not with this artist. She actually put some real effort and some production into the music, and she has a really clean voice. So great voice. I also like going to concerts in small venues as well. I like to go to big stadiums or whatever, spend $600 and you mostly hear other people screaming like a lunatic. But anyway, this couple said that the food around here is actually pretty good, so I'm gonna check this out. She's gonna be in DC afterwards. Yeah, so Kimbra, she released a fourth album called Reckoning, which I listened to for the first time driving down here, so I actually enjoyed that. I'm just really excited about this. And I don't know, I might stay in North Carolina overnight. I might do that, figure out what else I could do in town. But yeah, that's what I'm up to right now. It's important to sort of enjoy things, even as things unravel as far as the U.S. empire, so to speak. One thing on my mind right now is, you know, Biden. You hear a lot of talk about impeachment. I can't stand the concepts of recalls and impeachments, because I think that voters should deal with the consequences of their actions. If they elect somebody who is terrible, they should deal with those consequences. But I also think that there needs to be some level of accountability if a politician, a political leader, betrays the country and does something that really hurts the people. And so I was really frustrated when they impeached Trump over questionable reasons, stupid reasons, really, especially the January 6th, all this other stuff. That Russian story turned out to be completely bogus. And of course, there was talk about Biden, impeaching Biden. You know, if we're always talking about impeaching somebody just because we don't like them politically, then when they do something terrible, then, you know, people aren't going to, it's like the boy who cried wolf, people aren't going to take you that seriously. So anyway, I think Biden, if this story is true about Biden using the U.S. Navy and some CIA assets, basically using the military to actually attack Germany, another country, an ally, attacking that pipeline, if that's actually true and it looks really bad, then how is that not an impeachable offense? You know, really, how is that not an impeachable offense? I'm just wondering. You know, this is something, it's completely unconstitutional. Congress is supposed to declare war. We're not supposed to be attacking people. I can see if the country was under attack and he took action to defend the country. But to actually have this pipeline attack Germany's infrastructure seems completely crazy. Okay, so what's going on in the skies? Unidentified flying objects in Canada. There's a situation in Montana. Actually, part of the airspace in Montana was actually shut down because of national defense concerns. Apparently, they had some fighter jets scramble to deal with something that was going on there. This is really bizarre. Also in Canada, the Prime Minister of Canada ordered something to be shot down. It was an unidentified object. Apparently, it's a swarm of flying object. Apparently, they called in the F-22s. The pilots reported that the radar did not detect it. Very strange stuff going on right now. NORAD said that the aircraft was shot down yesterday over northern Alaska. It was not detected by radar early or by any early warning systems or anything like that, which is a bit concerning because you want to have something like that in place, and something like that should be functioning as part of our defense. Now, we don't know if it came from China. We don't know if it came from Russia. we don't really know if it's even something that came from a government, but it was something that they shot down. And I'll put a link in the description box, you guys can check out more of the information. It's very concerning, simply because we don't really know. It's just too vague for my taste. But anyway, my thoughts on the whole Biden situation. It's amazing how the media made such a big deal out of the classified documents in his garage story, but they're completely silent on the pipeline situation. Completely silent. And it just goes to show you that it's not really journalism anymore. The media isn't about reporting facts or the truth to people. It's just an extension of the propaganda machine. It's just there to push forward a narrative for the neocons, for the authority figures, the people in power, the people who really run the show. And I'm not necessarily talking about the politicians either. Those are my thoughts. Do you remember the Fukushima disaster in Japan? Well, after that situation, Japan decided to reduce its dependency on nuclear energy. And Japan only allowed about 10 out of 33 of their operational nuclear reactors to restart after the Fukushima disaster, right? But energy prices have gone up dramatically, and now they're doing a 180. Now they're going back towards nuclear. Apparently, on February 10th of this year, Japan's government adopted a policy seeking to maximize the use of nuclear power in a bid to stabilize the country's energy supply. And you're going to see this happen across the board. Germany, of course, shut down its nuclear power plants, its last three nuclear power plants, but at some point, they're going to have to do a 180 on that as well, because you know, if they can't get this cheap Russian gas, then how are they going to fuel their manufacturing sector? I mean, it's a situation that Germany's going to have to face, they're going to have to deal with, and they're going to have to make a change as well. Now, South Korea is really interesting because it looks like, well, we're going to see a change across the board with all of these, pretty much all these European countries, because you can't run cities, large cities, on wind and solar energy. It's not reliable enough. It doesn't give you enough juice. If you can't rely on coal and you're really obsessed with the whole green movement thing, then you're going to need nuclear. You have to run those reactors well. If you run it correctly and you're safe about it, then you can really have a really good energy source. But that's something that's going to happen. They haven't developed nuclear fusion yet. We're a ways from that, probably decades away from that. Right now, nuclear fission is going to have to be the go-to for a lot of these industrialized, developed countries. So share your thoughts on that. Share your thoughts on the Biden situation. a lot of Democrats really don't want this guy to run again, but certain people in this country can just do whatever they want because rules are made for some people and not others.